Alpacas, Pisco and Chewy are spending a hot summer day at a backyard party. As they play, they entertain children, who, due to the pandemic, couldn't go to summer camps and had to skip vacation. Owner Andrea Diaz grew up in Peru, where alpacas are sometimes kept as pets. When she moved to the US, she realized she didn't want to give up the family tradition.
These guys live inside my house, and they never were supposed to do anything besides my pets. But then COVID happened, and plans changed, right? So I wanted to join the parades that teachers were doing for the kids, because they were stuck at home.
Since the first successful event, Pisco and Chewy, themselves hungry for some socializing, started to drop by people's home to entertain and have fun. But it all started even earlier.
I saw that their logo was either a llama or an alpaca. It doesn't show very well. You guys can see it over there. And I was talking to Fito, the owner, and I was like, hey, wouldn't it be cool if we could like rent a llama or an alpaca for like a special occasion or something? And he was like, yeah, but no one does that. I'm like, well, I could get a couple because I have the space at home. I know how to take care of them.
Alpacas are extremely friendly and sociable. They don't kick, they don't bite, and most importantly, they don't spit.
The alpacas are so cute and fluffy, and people just love them in general, you know? So it was a great reaction. The kids love them, and it gives some families something to do too. The families would come and they want to bring the kids as well.
This is my first time I ever even met an alpaca. I never met one or seen one before. And they're so sweet, so if anything, it made my day better.
Diaz says Pisco and Chewy are very different. While Pisco is crankier and more inquisitive, Chewy is calmer and more shy.
I'm surprised to see the llamas. They're beautiful. And I'm actually feeding. It's my first time. They're adorable. Oh, you're so cute. I'm really impressed.
Alpacas are known for their wool that's believed to be one of the warmest and allows the animals to feel comfortable in the cold and this climate. And Diaz adds that keeping them at home is quite easy, though they're quite pricey, between $1,000 and $3,000.
If you don't have the knowledge to shear them, to do their nails, to give them shots and stuff like that, it can get a little bit pricey, just like a vet would for a dog. In my case, I do pretty much everything by myself.
In Virginia, where Diaz lives, alpacas are considered pets, so no license is needed to keep them at home. Maxim Moskalko for VOA News, Vienna, Virginia.